Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. It is Friday and we are in October, and I thought it would be kind of nice to do a Halloweenish tutorial. And in this episode, I'll show you how to do a hole in your hand effect. It's pretty easy to pull off as well. Also, this technique can be used for other things like putting a hole in your head, your stomach, whatever. Same technique, and I'll do that tutorial today for you guys. Also, if you are new to this channel and want to learn DaVinci Resolve filmmaking tips and tricks and want to have a look at some pretty cool gear, I would recommend you to subscribe. You could also join the Facebook group, and let's build a community over there as well. And if you really want to support the channel, you could actually join the YouTube member group by pushing the join down below. Alrighty, let's get right to this video. Okay, so let's get right to this. So we're going to use this clip right here with me putting my hand in front of my face, and we're going to make a hole in my hand so we can look through. And that's what we're going to do in this tutorial. So first off, we're going to select our clip, right click, and then we are going to do a new Fusion clip. Alrighty, with that out of the way, let's pop into Fusion. So inside of Fusion, we have our media in and our media out. And you know, I'm going to push Control Spacebar, and I'm going to find a planar track. I already did that, but if you push PL, it will pop up right here, and I'm going to add that into my composition. I'm going to push Shift and drag until it's in between our composition. Then I'm going to make sure I'm at the beginning of the clip, and then I'm going to go into the tracker, and I'm going to change the tracker from point to hyperpoint area. Then I'm going to make a square around my hand and go over to the inspector and push this icon here right here so I can track all the way through. And it should be good enough. It looks pretty fine already. There we go. Then we can go through our footage and see if that's a good track, and think that is good enough for jazz. So what I want to do now is I want to create a planar transform, because I'm going to need those in just 1 second. So I'm going to let that be here. So now I want to add some kind of a flesh wound or something. I have a flesh wound effect right here, as you see, but it could also be something like this, which is just a picture of a piece of meat done inside of Creed, and I just created a hole, and this is a PNG file. This is actually kind of similar. It's a flesh wound, and it has a hole, and it's a PNG file. So that's what we're going to use. I'm going to add this into the planar tracker, and then I'm going to go to the planar tracker, and I'm going to change the operation mode from track to corner pin. And then it's just a question of getting the corners onto my hand here and making this wound look nice. And you know, we can fiddle around with this for a while, but let's do this pretty fast. Perhaps something like this would be good. And then we can go through the clip and we can see that it's everywhere. Something like that. Looking good, I think. The track is good, so let's keep it like that. So now I want to create a hole in this file. And that's where the planar transform comes in. So I'm going to put in a background. I'm going to add that into the planar. And then I'm going to use a mask. In this case, I'm just using a polygon, and I'm going to connect that as well. So I'm going to select the media out, and then I'll just select the polygon as well. And if I use the control and the middle scroll wheel on your mouse, you can actually zoom in. And the idea is here to draw a mask around here. It doesn't have to be super perfect or anything, but something like that. And now I want to add this into my composition, and I can do that super easy just by dragging this and adding this into the media one. So that's going to create my merch. If you see this thing, nothing is terrible wrong, but that can actually be fixed pretty easy by going into the polygon, into the center, and we can just change it so it fits here. And then we could also make it a little bigger, like that. So now it should fit. So here we go. I'm going to zoom out again. So now we have this. And now we just need to actually make the hole transparent. And we are doing that by going down to the merge. And in the merge, we'll go into the operators and change this from over to X or R. And now we have a hole in our footage, as you see right here. So we simply just need to go back to the editing thing and finish up the last thing. So I'm going to move the fusion composition up. And then I have this clip over here, which is just me sitting still and blinking. And I'm just going to put this underneath. And I think this should be good enough. So there we are. Now I have a hole in my hand. So if it doesn't fit, you can go into the inspector here, into the position, and change up the positions here. Like so. I think that looks good. And then because I'm moving around the clip, I'm losing my bars here. So I'm just going to go into timeline and I'm going into output blanking, you know, and I'm just going to give it a little bit of a filmic look like that. So here we have the effect done pretty fast inside of DaVinci Resolve 17 and Fusion. Anyway, I do hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out, and if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.